Guys, I can't believe it. My Nemo Tensor sleeping bag finally failed me. It finally let me down out on the trail. And today we're gonna talk about what happened and whether I'm keeping this pad or I don't know if I'm still gonna use it anymore. But the main point of today's video is to talk about our value. First of all, I wanna mention what happened with this pad and what leads me to have that topic of conversation. But I don't know, it might be time to get rid of this pad. I'm just kidding. I'm still gonna use this pad. Guys, this is Southern Hike, I'm Taylor, and today we are talking about sleeping pad R value and about the Nemo Tensor and what happened to me. I have preached about this pad in multiple videos. I'll link the video above in my review a little over a year ago. And then I did a follow-up video. This has been a really good pad, especially living in Georgia. Some people would say it's a three-season pad. For us, it's a four-season. This will last you all the way through the winter where we live, where usually temperatures never get below the mid-20s or so. But I mean, we go trips all over the country, so you're definitely gonna deal with temperatures lower than that. So in our case, we do keep sleeping pads that are even more aggressive and higher R value for the temperature. So let me tell you, we just did a trip to the Smokies about a week ago, and we had two nights. The second night, it got down in the high teens. So yes, this is a 3.5 R value on this pad. So that is not what you want to use for that type of temperature. Definitely pushing this pad hard. But I was also had a good 20 degree sleeping pad. I also was wearing multiple layers, had a good set of wool on. So honestly, I was still warm. Here's where the problem started. So I got about 2 to 3 hours into my sleep and I noticed that something woke me up. I was starting to get cold on my hip. Well, I was like, why am I getting cold on my hip, especially from underneath? And then I noticed that, wait a second, my hip is laying on the ground just slightly, but my Nemo Tensor pad was bottoming out. And I was like, did I not fill it full of air properly? Or what's going on? I mean, even with the R value and it being in the mid 20s, I still should be okay with the amount of layers I was wearing. Well, I just lay there for a little bit longer, and then I realized my shoulder was starting to bottom out and I was getting even colder. And I was like, this ain't right. I am actually losing air in my pad. And it's the first time this has happened to me and having this pad the last couple years. I was very upset because it was our coldest night that I've experienced in a while. And I was like, this is the worst time this could be happening. So I actually got off my pad, pumped it all the way back up, slept for another 2 hours, same thing happened. First thing I noticed was not being uncomfortable. I started getting cold and it was coming from my hip. Same story, so I pumped it again. And believe it or not, I made it through that night sleeping pretty well, even though I had to get up twice and pump my pad again. I did not know what was going on. I didn't know if the top was not secure or it was leaking from the top. I really just didn't want to stay out of my sleeping bag long because it was just so cold out. And honestly, it was a slow enough leak where I was able just to go ahead and keep repumping it, even though it was frustrating, and get back on my pad and try to get through the night. The point of this video is to talk about R value and why it's so important. But I also want to say that I ended up finding the leak at home. I stuck this pad into the tub, ended up being a very small pinhole. And I've heard in reviews in the past this has happened. Honestly, this is the first time I rolled my pad up instead of putting it in the sleeve to protect it more and put it in my pack. I don't know if something just barely grazed it or pinched it or what happened, but I guess it's the price you pay for ultralight material is that you can run into situations where you get pinhole leaks. It was so small that the only way I could find it was putting it in water. I couldn't even hear it, it was so small. But it was definitely taking about 2 or 3 hours. I'm about 195 pounds, so it was able to push enough air out that I finally bottomed out. I patched it with the kits included. I'm still gonna use this pad. So this video, even though it's titled Talk About It Failed Me, I'm still gonna use this pad. I enjoy this pad. I'll make sure to continue to keep patches with me, but honestly, for the amount of times I've used it, if it's the first time I got a hole in it, I'm really impressed with how well it does. And that, guys, is why R value is so important. If you're new, if you clicked on this video and you're just getting into backpacking, trying to find a good sleeping pad, you have to be so important to make sure you're getting the right R value pad based on the weather you're gonna be in. If you're in the summer, honestly, minimum R value is fine. But if you're gonna be in the deep winter, which I hope you're not doing as a beginning backpacker, you definitely wanna invest in some real gear for that. You're gonna want something up to a 6 or 7 and one of the big thermarests. But like the Nemo Tensor, that's a good middle of the line if you're trying to stay light, but there's a lot of other great pads out there too. Some of them are a little heavier. They still give good R values from 3 to 4 to 5, but it's important that you have that R value. Whether one of those Z fold-ups, whether if it's a self-inflating, whether if it's you inflate the pad, it's important to have that R value, especially in spring, fall, and winter. If you're gonna deal with any cool temperature tonight, if you lay straight on the ground, you're gonna absorb all of that ground temperature, and I promise you, you're gonna be miserable and never be able to sleep. So it's important to have the right R value for every condition. There's a whole bunch of science that goes into it with radiation and convection. And then what happened in my pad was, is when it started failing, my pad bottomed out and I was basically straight across the ground and I lost all that R value. And all the cold from the ground was going right up into my body. It was absorbing all my heat out. And therefore I knew real quick what the problem was. It was crazy that what woke me was not the uncomfortableness of it pushing on my hip. The fact though that I had lost all that warmth so fast and it would wake me right up. So it's important to understand why you need that R value, especially if you're gonna be out there and you're new. I mean, all the experienced hikers guys, comment below how important that R value is. It's not just about your sleeping pad, because when you lay on your sleeping pad, honestly, that bottom part of your sleeping bag has no value to it at all. So it's important that you have the proper R value in that sleeping pad. And honestly, if you're using a quilt, that's what the benefit is just right onto that pad, and therefore the R value of that pad is protecting your bottom side, and you're losing the weight that you have to carry for a full sleeping bag with a quilt. So that's the thing about it, is always be checking the R value. If you're new here buying a sleeping pad and you're looking, trying to figure out what exactly is the right R value, definitely checking the pads that are probably 3+ for anything below freezing. You're still kind of risky even with 3+, but you're definitely gonna all the way down to 0 degrees. You're definitely gonna want something like a 6 or 7. That's why R value is so important. If you have any questions about this, please comment below. We'll be glad to answer them. It made me think about it when I got stuck in this situation. I'm like, wow, this is exactly why your sleeping pad is so important, and the R value and what temperatures you're in, because it will ruin your trip if you are cold on the ground trying to sleep. You just won't be able to do it. It will take all the warmth right out of you. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like it below. We'd really appreciate it. If you're new here, we are Southern Hike. Make sure to subscribe if you're new. Make sure to hit the notification bell below. We do a video every Tuesday afternoon or Tuesday evening, and we try to give you content every week. We are gladly going into some trips this summer and excited to share them with everyone. I've also got a review coming up about that Outdoor Vital Satellite Backpack. Make sure to stick around for that review. As I promised, it's coming very soon. I'm just trying to make sure that I've experienced it enough to give a good review and give an honest review about how I've enjoyed it so far. And the good news is I'm very excited about this backpack. It's done very well with me so far, and I want to share it with y'all. Guys, again, I hope you enjoyed this. Have a great week as we move into the spring. Everybody's about to get out and backpack, and I know everybody's getting geared up because a lot of people don't winter camp. So everybody's super excited. I hope y'all are enjoying this. I hope this was informative, y'all, and we'll see you next week.